Hello everybody, how's it going? This is Ekiman, and welcome back to another episode of our Monster Hunter 3 playthrough. Okay, so it's been a while since our last episode of this, and we need to unlock the urgent quest so that we can move on. So, as far as I understand it, we need to make the ancient mask. Okay. Right, what have they got to say now? Let's have a talk to them. To reach Briny Deep of Dragon Cave, Hunter needs Shaka special equipment for holding breath. Yep. Okay, we'll go take a look at that mask then. Let's see what he's got to say. Right, he wants it as well. and what does he have to say? Yeah, it's all about the mask. Alright, we'll go check that out. Yeah, it's only going to fit one of those guys, so they're going to have to fight it out for it. Anyway, let's go behind the farm and check that mask out. It's up here, I believe. No? Oh, you idiot. No. That's the exit to Mogul Woods. Let me just grab a drink of coffee here. And that's not where we need to be. Can I go back into the farm from here? Yes, we can. Excellent. Right, so let's see if we can find it properly now. Ah, that's right. It's through here, behind the waterfall. There we go, and we now have the ancient mask. So, as you read, that should enable one of these guys to be able to breathe underwater. That's for something a bit later, though. So, let's go see if that opened up our urgent quest. Let's see what she has to say. Yep, it looks like it might have done. So it stands atop some ancient ruins. If the folk back then had some kind of mask for breathing underwater, I bet they hung out at the bottom of the sea. Yeah, I know what's coming up there, so... but I won't spoil it anyway. What have we got here? Yes, the Rathalos. Okay, I love this fight. This is... a lot of fun. Oh, right. I thought it was going to be the Urgent. What have we got here? Oh, a Diablos as well. And a Barioth, right. But today, we are going to do a Rathalos anyway, so... Let's just grab that, and it's in the volcano area as well, so we could do with taking some cool drinks with us as well. But before we do that, let's grab a meal. And you know what we're going to go for? The same as we normally do, and we want fire resistance for this. Actually, that'd be quite good as well. But yeah, we want fire resistance, because Rathalos is like the male version of the Raytheon, and has some very similar attacks. It also does fireballs... But it's a bit more aggressive, to be honest. Excuse me. Cool drinks. Okay, we're going to take a full stack of those. And that should be all we need. Let me just check my... Yeah. Yeah, I absolutely love this fight. This guy used to be the poster monster for the original Monster Hunter. And man, have I spent many, many, many hours fighting this thing. Basically, it used to be like a key point in the first game. Everyone wanted Rathalos gear, or you wanted bits off of it for weaponry and stuff like that. So it was always a fight that was being done a lot online. Sorry, just getting some more of my coffee there. There used to be a quest called Rulers of Heaven and Earth. I believe there is a similar one, if might even be the same title in this game. And in that quest, you've got to fight a Rathalos and a Raytheon on the same map. And that used to be a firm favourite amongst us. It's a very fun fight. And it was one of the quicker ways to get in a bunch of really good gear. So if you wanted to get someone caught up with you quite quickly, you would do a load of... You would take them on Ruler of Heaven... Blah, I can't get my words out today. You would take them on the Ruler of Heaven and Earth quest. And that's how you do it. It was good XP, it was good gear. If they weren't ready to fight it, you could always sort of hide in a different zone, but not many people really did that. Everyone fought it. But yeah, it's a lot of fun. I really like this fight. And it's only got better with... Oh yeah, we need a cool drink. It's only got better with this version as well, if you ask me. The Rathalos now has a bunch of new moves. Where's it going to be, though? I think it probably would have been in Area 1. So, let's go through 6. Whoa, what was that? Ah, never mind. That looked like something I could... No, I'm going to go find it. I'm going to go find what that was. Oh, right, it's just seeds. Fire herbs and stuff like that. Actually, well, maybe we could check this because we need the seeds that you can make the attack up potions with. We've got the defense ones, but we don't have the attack ones, and they are from this... from the volcano area, I believe. Okay, so nothing yet. Just having another bit of my coffee here. Sorry, guys. It's early in the morning, so this is part of my breakfast. God, I cannot get my words out. This is part of my breakfast, technically. That and a big bowl of Rice Krispies. Okay. Yeah, we're not worried about you guys. We just want the big man. The big man himself. We need lots of bits and pieces off Rathalos as well, so I'm going to need to fight this thing quite a few times. I would like to make the armor off of it because I'm sick of running around in this gear that I've got. I've basically only had 2 sets of armor in about 40 hours of gameplay. And the first was I bought a hunter's set right at the beginning just to get me going. And then I upgraded to this. Okay, so I was wrong. Area 8. Yeah, and then I upgraded to this set of gear when I fought the Azur. Whatever it is, Azurlos, I think that's right, the bear monster. No, I want to go that way. And basically I've just upgraded it using armor spheres, which increases the defense on the gear. But it's getting to a point now where I really need to replace it because there are better armors available with a higher starting defense, so we could actually use armor spheres on those to get a better piece of armor. Okay, so it should be in here, I think. Yeah, we've got a cutscene. Oh yeah, he's a mean one. I really love this fight. So good. So this is the first time I've fought him in 3 Ultimate. I fought him tons in Try, the first game, the second game, all the PSP games. Here goes a roar. I meant to try and Superman dive through that. Might have to turn my headphones down a little bit. There we go. Okay. So, we've got him painted. Let me just assess the situation here. Let's get in there. So, attacking this guy is much the same as going after the Wraithian. Oh dear. Except he has a lot more flying attacks like that. But, essentially, he will do charges. He will do fireballs. I don't think he poisons. Don't think he's got the tail whip, but he has a pin move. Take that right in your face. Oh dear. That didn't damage us too much, actually. Yeah, like I was saying, I've upgraded this Azurlos gear quite a bit now. So even taking a tail whip doesn't actually damage us too badly. Oh, we just got out of that fireball in time. Meaning he's taking the cats out. We don't appreciate that. Although that means they should technically start helping us out now. Turn into this. Oh, he didn't. Yeah, this fight is actually very different to how it used to be. Like I say, he's got more or less the same moves. There's a lot more airborne now. Online, it'd really help to have a gunner. Yeah, I don't think we're going to make him in time to get the shot off. Maybe though. Nope. Yeah, he's a lot more airborne in this fight. And he can go from a charge to being airborne as well, which never used to be the case. Oh, man alive. What's with my aim today? Two shots not connecting. And nearly walked into that fireball. Yes, okay. This is what we need to do. We need to get the staggers going. We need to get him knocked down. And we can break pieces off of his head. Oh dear, this is not good. But I had no need to panic because our armor's pretty good. Even for low level gear, it's still not too bad. Whoa. Yeah, we need to wear his stamina down and hopefully he won't fly half as much then. Well, that tail shot seemed to flinch him quite a bit. Running out of stamina as well. We're not running out, but we're not at max anymore, so I'm going to have to think about sorting that out. Just land on the ground, man. Land on the ground. That move he did there, that's a pin move. If he gets you with that, you're pinned to the ground while he chews on you a bit. Bit like that attack, the jiggy thing had. Oh, we really need some water. What have I got? Nothing. Oh, not again. We just cleared this. Right, as long as we stay clear of him. All that health in our red bar should have come back, but of course it doesn't because we're burning. I really should have brought some more equipment with me to deal with that, but I wasn't. Must admit, I was relying on the fact that I fought this thing a lot of times. I wasn't thinking it was going to give me too much trouble, but I should have known better with this guy. There's a reason why he used to be the... Just rolled into a flame spot. Yeah, there's a reason why this guy used to be... poster boy of Monster Hunter 1. But we've got a knockout on him. It looks like we've broke his headpieces. Whoa, that was close. Yeah, we're just sort of not getting... There we go. Come on. One more. Yes! Let's get out of there. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Yeah, he's out of stamina, so he can't fireball us anyway, but still, you don't want to get caught in the front of that attack. Yeah, keep doing your fireballs. Open yourself up for all these headshots, guy. Yep. Come on. That's it. Ah. Mishit. Never mind. And I didn't realize my stamina was so low. There's an item in the game, Mega Dash Juice. We need to start making some of that, really. What that does is it prevents your stamina going down while you're charging up your hammer and stuff, or while you're running. It's only a limited thing. It doesn't last the whole quest. But yeah, that is very, very useful as a hammer user, obviously, because I think we probably use our stamina the most out of all the weapon types. Right, we need a cool drink as well. Okay, we've got some flash bombs. We can maybe think about using a flash bomb or two on this guy. I think he's going 7, I guess. Let's head this way. That's not the right way. Actually, I'm going to move over there. Let me just use a whetstone. Yeah, I'm going to move over there slowly so I can drink my coffee. Oh, no, I'm down at my last sip anyway. Okay, I'm ready. Right, so we'll just run down to Area 4 and give him what for. 4's not an ideal place to fight him, though, because it is quite a small area compared to these large ones. But that could work in our advantage, because it means his charges won't go as long, and we'll have less distance to cover for the headshots. So, it could work out. Of course, by the time we get there, he might just take off and fly away. This was always one big problem with Rathalos, the amount of times he would just fly off or just spend time flying around. Like I said earlier, it really did or does help to have a gunner on this quest to shoot him out of the sky. And also, you can't really... Oh, no. Roll. At least we're near some water if he gets us with a fireball. Okay, turn into this. Yes. Oh, I thought we could have rolled through that. Yeah, you can roll through his tail whips and his fireball, actually, if you time it right. Of course, it's very risky, so we're not going to do that right now. Oh dear. Oh no, I thought he was coming this way. Come on, land. Whew. See if we can get another knockout going on this guy. You can also break... Excuse me. Can break his wing claws as well. What else can you break? You can chop his tail off. And maybe you can affect his feet claws as well. I can't quite remember. But definitely wings, head and tail on this guy. And he is weak to dragon element, and his weak spot's his head as well. Just in case you were wondering. So that works doubly well for us as a hammer user. Yeah, and the main hammer I used to use on Monster Hunter 1 was a dragon element hammer. Called the Dragon Breaker, I believe it was called. It was made from the toenail of a Lao Shan Lung, which was one of the largest monsters in the game back then. And that thing used to absolutely destroy this guy. I mean, it would really wreck him. But unfortunately, we have no Dragon Element hammer right now, so we're going to have to make do with this. Let's just go put ourselves out in the water. We got first aid meds already. Yeah, this guy's ripping through our supplies. Yeah, you think he's going to be as easy a fight as the Raytheon, but he always surprises you. He's vicious as this guy. Just like that. Of course, in high rank, he just gets really, really tough. Those fireballs can absolutely wreck you if you're not careful. He's in rage mode. He's raging. Oh, excellent. I was going to use a health potion then. Yeah, you can teach the minions... some of you already know this, because no doubt you'll all be... some of you are Monster Hunter players, but you can teach your minions to do different dances. And those dances have different effects, like they can raise your attack, your defense, or as you just saw then, they can heal you. And you can change those. They learn different dances as they level up. Or dependent on what mask they're using, maybe. No, the mask is the ability, dictates the ability they can use. Like you just saw, we got that ancient mask, and that meant they could breathe underwater. I haven't upgraded their masks yet, because I don't see the point. I can beat most of these things on my own pretty easily. He's just regained his stamina by eating one of those Aptonoth things. I think that's right. Whatever they're called. Yes! Alright, we've got another knockout. Let's get a triple pound going. Yeah, take that, buddy. Oh, no, not a bouncer for wing. Please, come on. Yes. No, the third it didn't strike. I mean, it got the wing, but as you saw, made that dull bouncing noise. So, I think that means it only does a quarter damage, and it actually it makes our sharpness go down faster than it normally would. Have we got any water I can roll in here? Nope. What about here? Nope. I think, actually, what am I doing? I think if you just keep rolling... Yeah, it eventually puts it out. So, I've been wasting time and potions. Whoa! When I could have just been rolling. Any rations left? Yes, we got rations. Let's have that. And he's got me. No problem. It was worth it. Even though we did get knocked out of the area. Right. Let's get it on potion. Alright, you're ours now, buddy. You are ours. So yeah, there are actually different colour variations of this in the game, I believe. In Monster Hunter Tri on the Wii, they didn't have those. This was something that came in with the PSP games, I believe. Maybe someone can correct me on that. You could fight like an Azur Lassalos. You could fight an Azur Rathalos, a Silver Rathalos, they had a pink Raytheon, gold Raytheon, and obviously the standard green. And all those would make the different colour variants of the armour. Actually, I believe Azurlos... How was it silver? One of them was a lot stronger than your regular Rathalos. Whoa! Which is generally the case with the subspecies. The new stuff is always tougher than the old stuff. Anyway, that fight is back in the game, and I think it is in the tower area as well, which is a really cool map. He is nearly down for the count, guys. Yeah, which is a really cool map area that hopefully we will get to take a look at soon. I believe most monsters in this game have different colour variants. Oh, no! No! Paints ran off. We're going to have to hunt this guy the old way, which means he might regain his health. always paint your target, guys. Always paint your target. Well, I guess it can only be in a few different areas. What do you've gone to 10? Is that the nest? No, that's not the nest, is it? Okay, we're gonna have to find this guy. Yeah, what was I saying? There are different variations of most of the monsters in this game. That was something that Tri was actually lacking. I really liked Monster Hunter Tri on the Wii. However, it was lacking so many monsters that from the older version. I mean, it had a bunch of new stuff. But overall, there were less fights in Tri than there were even on the... It was a big step backwards from the PSP version, put it that way. Monster Hunter Freedom Unite 2, is that right? That was just like the ultimate. That was absolutely brilliant in my opinion. I'm going to have to check Area 10, aren't I? I don't think he's going to be there, but where else would he nest? Yeah, that had so many different varieties of fights, and it had like everything from the older games plus the new games. It was really cool. There's a particular fight in here that I'm going to be quite sad I can't show you guys, and that is the Yan Kukku. And that is really the first decent-sized monster you ever fight in Monster Hunter. And he was a lot of fun to... This isn't it. I really thought he might have come here. That was a lot of fun to fight. Little easy, but it was a fun fight. And he also had a variant called the Yan Garuga, which was a very tough fight. And a lot of fun. Where is this guy? Right, he wasn't in 8. We ran through 8. He wasn't in 7. We ran through 7. We need to check. Let's have a look in 3, maybe. So, I'm running in entirely the wrong direction. Let's head down this way. I wish I could remember where he nested on this one. But, never mind. It shouldn't take us too long. He can only be in... one of several places, and this ain't it. So, that leaves us with Area 6. Unless he's rehealed and moved on. In which case, he could be anywhere. So we need to go down here, that's right. Let's get a paint ready. I don't want to lose this guy again. Maybe we'll use a flash bomb as well, just to keep him in the area. You can actually throw those while he is airborne, and it will knock him out of the sky as well. So they are very useful. Where is this guy? Okay. That's a disappointment. We checked 3, didn't we? Been everywhere then. Where can he have gone? Back to 1, maybe? Oh, by the time we find him, he's going to have healed up as well. Right, we're going to have to check Area 1 then, I guess. Let's go this way. Actually, we can probably cut through 3. Oh, there he is, there he is. We got him. I really didn't think he'd be here. Didn't we run through this zone as well? Maybe not. Okay, let's see if we can finish this guy off. Let's get a well-done steaky and top up our stamina. Right. Is he going to try and attack that Rathalos? Good luck, buddy. He is. Oh, no. He's given up. He's realized that's a bit of a crazy maneuver. Or maybe he was just leaving the area. He's probably just leaving the area still. It would have been funnier had he been attacking it. I think they are. Maybe, anyway. Whoa, get out of the way. I think it's actually possible to roll through those roars. But I can never really remember. Don't be going anywhere. Oh, well. At least he's paintballed. We can follow this guy pretty easily this time. Let's just get the flash bomb ready for this. 6. He's probably not going to stop there. Yes, he is. Okay. It's not too far for us. No problem. I need to take some of these guys out soon, I think. Or the boss version of them. I need some new items for this hammer. Again, we've been using the same gear and weapon for a while now. I want to get some new things done. But there wasn't a lot of point in making some of the armor because I just didn't really need it. Until you start coming up against fights that are basically using more of your potions, there's not a lot of point in wasting materials on upgrades. If you can do it anyway, if you can sort of hang tight, it's better to have a nice supply of... oh, he must do poisons then. Cha-Cha's been poisoned. I wonder if we can get a third knockout. Probably not. Looks like he's going to die before we get the knockout. Come on, come on. Ah. Land and turn, land and turn. Not over there, though. Near us. Get mid-charge? Nope. Did manage to stop him before he flew, though. Turn into this, buddy. Yep. Although it's a fast turn, we need to get out of there. Yeah, fast turn usually means he's going to charge right after it. Or it used to do, anyway. Could have changed in this one. But generally, when anything does a fast turn, you want to get away from it pretty quickly. Yeah, we're too far away. Yeah, at a certain point, you kind of can't... Once you've committed to that charged spin move, you've committed to it, unfortunately. Let's try and roll this off. There we go. Heal up, and then I think it's time for a flash bomb. Should have used one already, really. Whoa! I thought he was going to come charge at us, so there we go. Oh, I could have gone off a second earlier and saved us that. No problem. So here's another one who will still attack while he's stunned. He will do tail whips. Oh, someone else got the killing blow. Excellent. Okay, well, that's the Rathalos dead. Put up quite the fight. I was actually expecting this to be a 10-minuter, and it turned into a good 20 minutes, so... I guess that's the episode today, at least, anyway. But we have unlocked a couple of new monsters to take a look at as well. Although, the Diablos and the Barioth are going to be much, much harder fights than we've come up against so far. Just kick this guy in the face. I might actually just grind a few Rathalos fights out and upgrade some of my gear and weaponry. Sorry, mate, I didn't mean to kick you guys. Get out of the way, though. Yeah, I might aim for some Rathalos gear, or at least the Rathalos hammer, because that has a fire status element to it, and I believe Barioth is an ice-based monster, if I remember rightly. So it should work well on that. Alright, let's see what we got in the quest rewards. I'm hoping for an Inferno sack. Might have to capture him for that, or might even have to kill a high rank. What did we get? Scale, webbing, fang, flame sack. Oh well. Marrow, shell, scale, no plates. Oh man, Rathalos plate. Oh! I was just about to tell you a story about how difficult and rare... Like, I only ever got one or two of these things when I used to play Monster Hunter 1. This is why I used to fight Wrath so much, because plates were like endgame items, really, that you needed for lots of stuff, and now they just sort of, they drop like they're going out of fashion now. It's rubies, I believe, are the hard things to get. Rathalos rubies. And we need some of that stuff for high rank gear. But right now we should be okay. Yeah, let's save our progress. And let's just quickly check what we can make with his pieces. Let's have a look here. Can we make any new hammers? No. Can we upgrade our hammer? Let's have a look at this one. No, I need carbolite ore, which is in the next tier of quests, so that's good. We can start upgrading that. That's going to go down to a gun hammer at some point. Although, I would kind of like to make a paralysis hammer, so I don't know. Jury's out on that one. Yeah, we need an Urrigan and some Mega Demon Drug as well. So that should be coming up soon in the next tier of quests. This guy, I already know what he needs. Inferno Sack and then a few things from the Karupako. I think that's right, anyway. But then there's also this as well, the Red Bludgeon. Let me just see, how can I get the display up? So as you can see, that's like a Rathalos head on a stick. Now, is that a badass hammer or what? It also makes the Rathalos roar as well when you use it, and it has a fire element. So, I mean, look at that. It's just like, it's like duct taped to a bit of bone. That is just so awesome. So yeah, we might actually make that. That only needs 3 more shells and we can make that. That's a 728 with 120 fire. That's 728 with 140 fire and a better sharpness as well. Oh, and it's a 15% affinity as well, which is critical hit chance, I believe. So I don't know, maybe we will just go for the Pekko Flint, although it doesn't look as cool at all, does it? Kind of good, but not quite as cool. What have we got here? Red Bludgeon, Numbing Bird. That's the worst of them, of the looks anyway. But paralysis status is pretty cool. Anyway, before I get lost talking about this for another 20 minutes, let's just quickly check this. Wrath Talon. Yeah, we need to go at its feet then. Oh no, that's the wings. It's the wings. Can we make it? Come on. Can we make a chest? No, we can't. But yeah, look, that starts with a defense of level 22, and if I, you can see my Azuros, that's right, Azuros, whatever it is, that's actually at 21 defense now, so I would only be gaining an extra point, but the Azuros armor is at level 5, and the Rathalos is at level 1, so that is what I was talking about earlier, these armor stones. You can click on this now. And we would actually need a advanced atmosphere, which are from the next tier of quests, to upgrade this. What that actually means is, to a certain degree, you can keep low-level armor going if you want, if you really like the look of it, which is really cool, I think. But I've been looking at this armor and this hammer for long enough. I've been looking at this for long enough. So, we are going to make... We're going to make this. Am I? I'm going to make it. Might have been a bad move. There's probably better weapons I could have made, but I really like this. So let's just... there you go. So now we've got like a samurai sword katana kind of thing. But yeah, we'll take a look at that in the next episode, because I'm going to go on a tailing rampage and try and chop off a bunch of tails. So I think I will probably leave this episode here for today. Let's just have a look here. Oh, we need Plesioth gear. That guy, that's such a nasty fight is that one, but you'll see soon enough. oh, we need a vault stone as well. So we could almost upgrade that pretty soon as well. Anyway, yeah, I'm going to leave the episode here, guys. So I hope you've enjoyed watching this. I'm out for now, and I will see you soon for some more Monster Hunter 3. Peace.